So let's start with this first session. We are continuing away from where we left off last night because we were talking about operations in protracted crises, how to tip the balance, if you like, towards localization and to deactivate clusters. It's a really, really tough thing. We heard about how in Nigeria and the Central African Republic, it's really very, very difficult. And today we're talking about Syria and South Sudan, both very complex situations. So Gilles Simtiere is with us again. He is going to provide the opening for this session. He's the GLC Field Support Logistics Officer. Gilles.
One of the Global Logistics Cluster Logistics Officer. Thank you for your participation at this second session of 1 hour, which aims to continue the discussion that we had yesterday. The content of this session is first a short summary of the perspectives and plan for 2021, also presented yesterday. Second, how in the long term can we address the humanitarian logistic challenges beyond the presence of a logistic cluster? In this regard, we propose you today to go through another two logistic cluster long-running operations, South Sudan and Syria. Yesterday, we had Central Africa and Nigeria. Then we would like to hear from you, knowing that some participants may have already engaged in the previous discussion yesterday, include the proposal for quarterly global calls on operation. Thank you. Here is a short overview of some aspects that we would like to share with you on the logistic cluster operations and perspectives for 2021. This year, the gap and needs analysis in existing and future operations will continue to be developed. The general objective of the GNA is to assess existing and potential logistic gaps, constraints and needs for which the logistic cluster support might be requested by partners. GNA provides the rationale on the potential need of a cluster activation or of an alternative coordination mechanism endorsed by the humanitarian community. Since January 2021, GNA have been conducted in Myanmar, Venezuela, and is currently taking place in Syria. In addition to the above, we have also planned a review of our response strategy in countries where the context and the needs have evolved, such as in Bangladesh, DRC, Pacific region, and Yemen. In this regard, we would like to propose to have a quarterly global call on operations with partners who wish to be engaged at global level in the strategic review of logistic cluster country operation. This global call can include any operation and country where the logistic cluster is present. Here is the second key point of this session. We would like to hear from you as participants, your views on strategy and response in long-running operations, more than 1 year and more, including in protracted crises like in Central Africa, Nigeria, South Sudan, and Syria. How, in the long term, can we address the humanitarian logistics challenges beyond the presence of a logistic cluster? In this regard, we propose presentation by logistic cluster field teams of some of the long-running operations and the respective challenges identified by the teams and partners in 4 countries: Central Africa and Nigeria on Monday, South Sudan and Syria on Tuesday. Then we would like to hear from you, participants, and to know your view on possible opportunities for transition, during and beyond the presence of a logistic cluster, possible opportunities for localization, other opportunities. To do so, we'll have space for discussion after the presentation made by field teams, which is following. Thank you.